Fuck off.
Their rows are legendary.
No, I haven't got a bloody Oscar. I'm not being sworn at.
They're driving the locals away.
Out. Yeah. What I've heard, he's a bit of a tosser.
I'm turning marriage counsellor.
You can't run around like fucking Shrek in a frock. You've got to have some form of control.
Otherwise, this restaurant will self-destruct.
Ding, ding, round fucking two.
Lampeter, a tranquil hamlet in West Wales's glorious countryside. A perfect setting for a traditional rustic restaurant.
I mean, it's a dream for any chef to have a restaurant here. Phenomenal pastures, amazing land, great support by the locals. But trying to understand the fuckers is a completely different nightmare.
Hello and welcome to Teach Yourself Welsh.
Shumai achroeso I Teach Yourself Welsh.
And remember to speak out loud.
College.
Chwech.
Chwech.
Six.
Cynta.
Cynta.
First.
I. Dim.
Dim.
No.
I feel fucking dim.
In this green and pleasant land lies the Fish and Anchor. A few years back, ex-boxer Mike Chiminera won 700 grand on the pools. It's allowed him to swap his fish and chip shop for the pursuit of his culinary dream.
I'd like to set a goal of just achieving something, be it like, you know, just get one Michelin star. You know, they put a man on the moon with no technology. You can put a man on the moon, Michelin star don't sound a very big thing to achieve, do they?
Mike's got a plan to make the step up from the fat fryer to the cooking odd cuisine, nicking recipes from cookbooks used in the home, including mine. Oh, ooby doo,
I wanna be like you. Gordon Ramsay's book there, Sunday Lunch, Rick Stein's book. Gordon Ramsay here again. I like to try and recreate them or put my own slant on a lot of them. Very simply, turn them into something really special and exciting.
But there's a problem in this Italian stallion's plan for culinary world domination. Mike and wife Karen, who runs the front of house, just don't see eye to eye.
Try to run up a hill with a ball and chain around your leg. You know, it's holding you back, it's slowing you down.
He is very critical of me. And I don't know why, because I do my job and I do my job bloody well.
You're supposed to work with me.
I am working with you, you freaking dog!
Married for 22 years, the couple's arguments are notorious locally. Mike and Karen have even got into trouble with the law for rowing in public.
Asshole!
We're having the row, and Karen's in my face, and I just pushed her out of the way, you know?
Yeah, so I shouted back, and I screamed back, and I give you a shove as well. Yeah. Two-handedly.
These two don't just row with each other, they also row with the customers. It makes for a stinking reputation and no one's coming here to eat. Hemorrhaging a grand a week, this eatery's heading for the big chopping board in the sky.
Oh my God. What is that down there? That can't be it, can it? You can't miss that one, can you? Unfortunately, the Germans did.
How are you, buddy? And this is Mike.
Yeah?
Mike, who's in love with blue.
Blue, yeah.
Fuck me, you can't miss it, can you?
No.
Huh? How are you?
All right, thanks.
Good, didn't realise you're so short.
Well...
short and powerful.
Yeah.
Hey, how are you? And this
Carol,
is...
Carol.
How are you?
Very
nice
good.
To see you.
And you?
And are you in love with blue as much as Mike?
No.
No?
No.
Thank fuck for that. Ronaldo. Zola. Fuck me. I didn't know sports bars existed in the middle of Wales. It's bright, it's ghastly, and, yeah, it's blue.
And another addition to this Hall of Fame is me. God. A fish recipe from one of my cookbooks using monkfish is on the menu board.
It's quite eerie when you see your own food on somebody else's menu. It's for the home cook at home, not in a fucking restaurant.
This menu's a mishmash of cookbook recipes. It's so vast, I'm dizzy reading it.
I'll start with the soup first, my darling, please, thank you.
First off, a nod to the great Giorgio Locatelli.
Very chunky, isn't it?
Yes. Well, nice.
Bloody hell. Do you interrogate all the customers?
I do.
You
do? When they're awkward ones, yes, I do.
No wonder they've fucked off.
No wonder, well they don't be awkward and facetious then.
That's the weirdest looking minestrone soup I've ever seen.
He's been a twat. Yeah.
Next up, let's see how my fish recipe stands up.
He's got black bream with a basil and pea bonne femme. I've changed that. I still use the bonne femme, but a roast fillet of monkfish.
Schlots are raw. Monkfish is actually quite nicely roasted.
Finally, a Madder Jaffrey tribute. That well-known Welsh classic, a chicken korma curry.
Looks like something out of a fucking pig's trough.
We had someone in, they'd been to Claridge's, run by Gordon Ramsay, and they thought that they enjoyed their food here a lot more than what they enjoyed it there.
What the fuck is that? Welsh knot. Fuck me, we don't need to see dessert, do we? Jesus. Shit. Happy to be here.
Yeah.
Just arrived, sat down, went through the menu. You've got everything and anything on there.
Part of it comes from, I see something and I like the look of it, I want to put it on the menu.
But the menu reads like a trophy chef. You've gone round and picked up all these little bits of... Like a fucking magpie.
Yeah.
Trophy, stick it on.
Yeah.
I was really excited about the fucking soup. When the soup arrived, just like a mush of fucking vegetables. The gunk, it was shocking. The monkfish, even the shallots were like raw, Mike. They weren't even cooked, so it was like a raw onion. And then the biggest kick in the bollocks was the fucking curry. That was shocking. Was that Lloyd Grossman's sauces?
No.
Uncle Ben.
No, he's a sword.
Yeah. Uncle Ben's.
Oh, yeah.
But that's what hurts. It causes more damage serving that. I like your fucking passion. That's clearly there. But you're not a chef.
No.
And that menu's full of your wish list.
Yeah.
Shite.
With no customers, it's obvious the Fish and Anchor's reputation is bad. Time to turn detective to see just how bad.
Fish and Anchor.
There are clues in cyberspace, recently posted reviews.
The food has to be the best I've ever eaten, home or abroad. Here's another one. I've been to Rick Stein's and I've been to Gordon Ramsay's, but to find a place better than them on my doorstep is a dream come true. Mike Burns.
Strange. The reviews are good. So good that there's something fishy going on here.
There's three reviews, all written by a guy called Mike. He's been to Rick Stein's, he's been to Gordon Ramsay's. It's all a little bit too familiar. To find a better place than them on my doorstep is a dream come true. A little fat fucker. Truthfully, okay, and you don't fucking lie to me now, nor you. Michael Burns, yeah? I don't get excited about food too often. And having dined at Rick Stein and Gordon Ramsay's, I think I found a better restaurant in West Wales. Long live the Fish and Anchor. Recommended, Mike Burns. Afghanistan.
Where?
That's Daniel's friend done that, didn't
it? Mike, truthfully,
yeah,
and I know the truth, which one of these three did you post on there?
This one.
Thank you. Yeah. Why?
Well, we just wanted to, we spoke to someone and they say people do these things from time to time to get themselves noticed, and that's what we done.
Can you blowtorch them, put some icing sugar on there, fucking caramelise them, or put them in the fucking bin? Thank you.
Professional cooking is a much, much, much tougher job than people like Mike think so.
You can't just go and nick recipes from cookbooks and, hey, presto, I'm a chef, and then write your own fucking reviews.
He's a sitting disaster waiting to happen.
Tonight, I've press-ganged some reluctant locals into eating here. I need to see how Mike handles cooking for a full restaurant.
With such a large menu like that, it must be a nightmare, no?
It is.
Do customers wait long for food?
Not usually.
Mike's confident, I'm not. His menu's made up of cookbook recipes designed for home cooks to lovingly slave over. But for one man to try and cook them from scratch for a restaurant is madness. The dishes are just too complicated to be cooked quickly. Mike's running around like a headless chicken.
Oh, shit. I'm doing it the hard way. I know that.
Fuck me, you're doing it the hard way, huh?
What's clear right now, Mike is obviously not a fucking chef. He should be cooking for three or four tables at the same time. He's not. He's only cooking for one. So it's like watching my mum at home cooking for a dinner party.
2 hours into service and the food's just not getting out.
They're
ordering, yeah? They haven't taken the order yet.
No.
It's like a famine. Customers are staving off hunger by eating bar snacks. With an unworkable menu, the service is spiraling out of control. The pressure's on this husband and wife team, and these two are going to war. Mike's even got his own Welsh battle cry for Karen.
Ka! What's going on?
What do you mean, what's going on?
These!
Well, what am I supposed to do? They've been there for fucking hours.
Ah, these tables are booked in.
Yeah?
It's fucking ridiculous.
Well, whose fault is that? Mine, is it?
This isn't a marriage, it's a battlefield. Their relationship needs some serious fixing. Outside, there's more trouble brewing.
So it was better for them to sit there where they were happy.
We've been waiting here since 8 o'clock. I'm going home. I couldn't give a shit about your crappy bloody pub. It's an absolute load of shite. We've got a 70-year-old bloody woman with us, and you haven't given me a bloody shit. And that's for you.
Well, that's your prerogative. I did apologise for the
yeah,
for the meeting. But there's no need to bloody swear and shout in front of everybody.
Well, I'm sorry, you know,
the
crap.
Yeah, well, don't bother coming back. Good. Bastard.
I can't believe what I'm hearing. There's no stopping this woman. There's a misunderstanding over an order. Karen's going off on one again.
Since 5 o'clock this morning.
Yeah.
I've come here especially for this.
I know you have.
And I've got nothing for it.
Well, whose fault is that? It's not my fault. You was the one that said you was leaving.
I didn't say we're leaving.
You said you was leaving.
Of our fucking thing are leaving.
Right, now I want you to leave now because I don't want to be thrown at. I've had a tidful tonight. Now if you want to swear at me again, you can leave right now.
Okay.
No, I haven't got a bloody answer. I'm not being thrown at.
Whoa.
Out. Leave it. Out.
Right. Spend 4 fucking hours.
Out. Right. So just get in your car and go.
Oh, dear.
This is a first for me. I've never, ever seen a customer chucked out of a restaurant like that before. That is fucking embarrassing. And no wonder this place is in serious trouble because that was appalling. What in the fuck have I got myself into here?
Hostilities have ceased. Almost half the customers didn't get served tonight. Mike and Karen have gone AWOL. The only sense I can get in this madhouse is from a 17-year-old waitress, Ang Haddad.
I knew it would be like this.
Yeah. Why?
Well, he just can't handle it.
No.
He talks a lot. Yeah, he thinks he can do it, but he can't.
And all the shouting, that's not normal, is it?
Yeah.
It's
always a bad
time. Honest to God. Tell me how you're feeling.
Pissed right off.
Yep.
I've had a titful, right?
Yep.
And I can give two shiny shites if there's 150 people out there waiting to get served.
Karen?
I feel as sick as a dog because I've been threatened, I've been called an old tart, I've been called a scrubber by customers. I have never, ever, ever had anybody talk to me like that before.
What went wrong tonight, Mike, is that you did one table at a time. 21 we cooked for, and you made it look like 201. It's the transformation from coming out of a cook to a chef. And I can see where you shot yourself in the foot, the fucking menu. If I was in here and asked to cook this fucking menu because you're on your bed upstairs, ill, I wouldn't even attempt to do what you did tonight. One thing, okay, tomorrow, even before I start looking at the menu, okay, the two of you, it's like you're having a fucking boxing match in here. It's husband and wife, right? That has to stop tomorrow. I see it all the time when customers are frustrated. The customer's king, Karen. You can't fucking round with them. It spreads like wildfire. Fuck me. Welcome to Lampeter. This is a fucking nightmare. Turning that place around, it's gonna take me a lot longer than fucking 12 rounds, I tell you.
I'm in Lampeter, West Wales, at the Fish and Anchor. Last night's service was a disaster. If things don't change, this place is going down, period. It's a reality check for chef owner Mike Chiminera. This ex-boxer's on the ropes.
It is gutting to know that you're not really going in the right direction. I mean, you're probably one step up from a truck stop in reality that's glorified. I'm still not going to give up. I'm still going to keep going, you know, but what my aim to do now is to listen what the Gordon says and absorb it all like a sponge, as much of it as I can, and point it in the right direction, just draw another deep breath and come back out fighting.
Time for a bit of tough love. My opening shot in helping Mike is to get rid of his comfort blanket, those cookbooks, including mine.
Right. Something that's fucking destroying you in here. You know that?
Yeah.
Something that is a big problem in this kitchen. Yeah. These fucking things.
Right.
Great recipes of the world. Out. Asian cooking by Uncle Ben. Sunday lunch. Not interested in that. Make it easy. Not interested in that. Rickstein, Mediterranean. Not interested. Come play with Jamie. Not interested in that. And Rickstein's French Odyssey. Bang. Get your coat. We're going down to the charity shop. I want to give something back to Lampeter. Reader's Digest.
I don't know where they come from.
Oh,
they come from
fucking hell. Don't tell
We've
me.
We've had them for years. I've had
Open the car door, please.
I've had them for 20 years.
Everything I've seen points to Mike trying to be someone he's not. Mock reviews, using other people's recipes. To help him, I need to find the real Mike, starting with his Italian heritage.
Who's that gentleman there?
That's my grandfather.
Wow. Italian?
Yeah.
Yeah, lovely. From where? From
Naples.
And
that's his parents, my great-grandparents.
Wow. Again from Naples?
Again from Naples.
They were farmers. Just worked the land. It all poor, put in the south of Italy, poor area.
Wow, so it's quite an Italian historic tree there. And that lady is...
That's my grandmother.
Basically, who I'd learned, you know, a lot of the Italian cooking. You know, basically, that's who I am. You know, we're proud of it.
There's been an Italian community in West Wales for years. Mike's passionate about this heritage. I plan to channel that passion into his cooking by making a classic Italian dish. My starting point, a nearby organic vegetable farm.
Peter, how are you?
Very well.
Good to see
nice
you. Well,
to see you. And
likewise. There's Mike.
Hello, Mike.
Mike's from the Fish and Anchor. We need a good service tonight.
Right.
Yeah, and we're going to come up with a dish that can get some traffic through the restaurant without becoming too concentrated and stuck.
I'm taking Mike back to his roots. Here, they grow the very tomatoes he tasted when he was a kid.
So, what are they called?
These are called San Marzano.
San Marzano.
And they're specifically for making sauces.
Yep. When was the last time you came picking tomatoes, Mike?
On my grandparents' farm in Italy. That's the last time I picked tomatoes.
Really? Which is how long ago?
30 years ago or more.
Oh, these are beautiful.
This is like being in a candy shop.
Yeah.
Huh? Absolutely phenomenal. Look at it. Everywhere.
It's been
different
many
variety.
Years since I tasted a tomato like that.
It's time for Mike to cook from his heart and not cookbooks. His grandmother's recipe for spaghetti meatballs.
Explain the perfect meatball.
Good mincemeat.
Yes. Combination of beef and pork.
Thyme.
Yep.
Parsley.
Yep.
Poppy
colour.
Chilli.
Mm-hmm.
Parmesan cheese.
Good. Could you say it was your grandmother who inspired you how to cook? Would you say that's where it started?
Yes.
Yeah? Because you're quite a passionate little fucker inside, aren't you?
Yep.
Huh?
Yes.
Mike's not a chef yet. He struggles cooking for a full restaurant. These meatballs are the first step in helping him.
Right, the emphasis of tonight's service is what?
It's to get the tables...
Speed.
Speed.
Speed, yeah. Speed, speed, speed.
Multiple portions can be pre-prepared and served up in a matter of minutes.
I don't care whether you've got 10 booked or 20 booked. I don't want customers waiting for that length of time again. Yeah?
Now, I'm going to cook from within myself. Find, you know, what's within myself and put that on a plate.
Do me a favour. Rub off that shit fucking tikka masala balti korma crap fucking shit off of there, yes? All off, one big swipe. There you go. Bang. Korma's off, yes? What's your wife's name?
Karen.
Ah! Ah! Can you call her Karen tonight?
Karen.
Yeah, no, but can you do it in a really affectionate way that you fucking love her?
Yeah.
As is a husband and wife team. Because the minute you two start fucking showing some form of affection and respect, everybody else follows. Ah! That was you grunting like a troll looking for your fucking spanner. No, but... serious? And I was standing there like that thinking, fucking hell, this guy's fucking bonkers. What's he smoking?
Tonight, I'm going to show Mike how meatballs speed up service. This place looks like a sports bar, so I've invited the local rugby club, 15 strapping lads. And they're starving hungry.
Are you on half term?
No.
We get that 15 out, yeah?
Right.
That's over one third of the dining room cooked for, okay? Come on.
It's taken just minutes to serve up the meatballs to the rugby lads. Job done.
15 drops, yes. Yeah, hey, 15 drops. We couldn't even get 12 starters out last night.
Yeah, nice. Yeah, spot on. Nice and spicy. Very good. I think. They look like faggots, but they taste like meatballs, Mike. It's called cuisine, man.
The kitchen's starting to come together. Out front, it's a different story. The restaurant's busy, but where's Karen?
Sorry. 2 seconds, please. Sorry, buddy. Okay. Thank you. You're not smoking, are you? Yes or no?
Yes.
That's disgusting. Come on, Karen, please. Now, I need everybody's help tonight. Right, come on, please. Yeah? Ridiculous. Come on. He's busting his ass off there. You're outside smoking. Take the order of six, please.
Now.
Now.
Well, he told me 2 minutes.
Karen? He told you 2 minutes, but does that mean to say you've got to go out and smoke a cigarette?
No, I didn't know.
I thought you were running the restaurant.
I am.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Dear, oh dear.
I'm not convinced with her. This, for me, is someone taking the piss like they're just going out tonight for a fucking game of bingo. She's got to attack it, run it, and observe it. But you can't disappear every 30 seconds for a cigarette, for a cigarette. What about customers arriving? And one of the owners outside puffing away. What kind of message is that sending to anybody? Karen's standards are sloppy, and it's showing. Now there's confusion over a table's order.
One fricassee, one monkfish, 3 halibut...
2 steaks.
And let's, 2 fillets.
Yeah, let's count this up, shall we?
Yeah.
2 plus 3 is 5.
Yeah.
Plus 6.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
7. You're missing a main course. We cooked exactly what you wrote. Can you go and ask the lady what she ordered, please?
Urgently.
Oh, come on. 1 venison in straight away, please. Okay, let me ask you a question now. Yeah, without getting defensive and running off in a strop.
No, I won't.
Why did you forget the venison on the order?
Because 2 people ordered the venison and then the
You crossed it off.
Yeah, but both of them cancelled it and then it was the halibut to go back on and then he ordered the venison again and I forgot to put it back on.
You forgot to write it on.
Yeah.
Tomorrow, we're having a lesson in taking orders.
Yeah.
Okay?
Fine.
Don't get upset.
I'm not getting upset.
We're in the shit. We look stupid.
No, you don't. Because let me finish.
Let me just finish.
Yeah.
By the time the venison's cooked and rested,
the
existing customers around the table, their fellow guests, will be on fucking dessert.
Right,
we, as a unit, look stupid. Yeah. Please don't tell me any different, because...
I'm not telling you any different.
Don't start shouting.
I'm not shouting,
you'll run off in a minute and start smoking.
I won't, but you're always in there. You're always
you just
willing
concentrate?
to give bloody...
So it's my fault now.
It's not just. I've just told you it's my. I've just told them it's
we
my fault.
We look stupid.
Yes, I do.
We.
But you, no, you don't, because I've just told them it's my fault.
You don't get it, do you?
Yes, I do.
You don't get it.
Oh, Gordon, you just love pick. That's all you've done for the last 2 days. You've said fuck all to him. But no, that's all it is. Is every time I come out here, I'm still not sure about you. That's all you've said all night.
You're going to run away now?
No, I'm not.
Customers can hear you.
My customers.
Customers can hear you.
Yeah, and they can hear you as well.
Is this what it's like? She forgets to write a venison and then shouts and screams and runs off. Yeah.
Well, I have a go as well. I have a go at you when you do that.
Please stop shouting.
And then you scream at me. So I
close the door. Let's stop the embarrassment further.
No. I'll talk tonight.
Oh,
I've gone out there.
I know what you said. I heard what you said.
What I was trying to say to her, is there any way she could recommend a meatball that's cooked so we can get it out quickly?
Yeah.
Rather than cooking the venison.
You don't have a chance to get it out.
Yeah? And I can't even get a fucking word in edgeways. At 8 o'clock this evening, I'm sweating my bollocks off trying to get this place up to speed, and she's outside having a cigarette.
Ha.
Ding, ding, round fucking 2.
I want him
Shut up, get it out. What?
I'm not being told.
You didn't let him
back off.
Shut your mouth and listen to me. You're doing the same. You're not listening to me, same as you don't listen to him.
I told him it was
You're doing it now. You're doing it now. You're doing it now.
Yeah.
You're not letting me finish like you wouldn't let him finish.
And he wouldn't let me finish.
Look, you're doing it again. You're doing it again. What he was going to say after... after he finished telling you what you've done, the next thing he's going to say is, I tell you what, why don't you try and get the sell him the last meatballs to get it out for the night? But you didn't give it a chance because, bang, you was there on the throat again. Now, I'd like you to get behind the bar where you should be and get Jane out from behind there. She's not allowed behind there. Right?
Don't
stop.
Expect me back tomorrow. Fuck off.
Just get it done.
Fuck off.
No, just get it done. You can't take it, Cassie, can you?
I can take it, but I don't like being told to fuck off.
The venison finally gets served.
I'm deeply concerned.
Yeah.
For the shouting and screaming, you're screwing the business. And the quicker you learn to control your temper, the quicker you're going to run your business. For the better. Let me finish, OK?
But I'm not allowed to finish anything. I was saying to you earlier, that's what I was trying to say to you.
Let me finish and then have your turn.
Is this a competition between you and
not.
I?
Let me finish and then you have your turn.
I don't know what you want me to say.
There you go again.
But I've gone up there, I've apologised. I can't do any more.
You can't run around like fucking Shrek in a frock and then expect us to pick up the pieces. You've got to have some form of control, Karen. You're more concerned about you as opposed to committed to the business.
I am not.
So you're making
mistakes. You want to go along with this, Mike? Go along with it, right?
Look, Karen.
Oh, so you're throwing the towel in?
Stop it.
Stop it.
Why do you work yourself up like this?
Because I've tried to tell you, I've gone out there, I've apologised, I can't do any more out there.
Let me help you.
Help me do what?
Run the dining room properly.
Yes, you can.
I'm just asking you not to snap. There's 20 mistakes going on in every restaurant across Britain every night. We have to control them. Your problem is, one mistake, you lose the fucking plot, my dear.
Yeah, but if
Please calm down.
I am.
Because then we can work at it together. We finished work, go outside and have a nice cigarette.
Thank you.
Get some fresh air.
Can I have a cigarette, though?
Huh?
Thank you for your help again.
Not at all. Hey, we got through it.
You sort of come like the fucking Italian job where the bus is on the edge of the cliff. You sort of arrived just at the right time. I'm like that bus ready to go over.
Get some fresh air. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. Don't leave me.
Come here.
Just
come
leave
here.
It.
Don't
leave it.
Look at me. Look at me. No.
To be left.
Look
alone.
At me. Look at me for 30 seconds, right? Just bear with it, right? It's hard. It's all in 1 week, right? And we're going to get it over and done with, right? And we'll be back on the right road. Just get it all over and done with, right?
Don't try and be reasonable, Mike.
I'm not, Ka, right?
Because if you spoke to me like that, what would you have?
I know that, right? But I override and respect, right? For the
yes,
man here is trying to help
well.
Us put the business right.
Oh. Fuck me.
I'm in Lampeter, West Wales, at the Fish and Anchor. I've been here for two nights of madness and mayhem, with the owners rowing with everyone. They've gone for each other.
I need one and I need Philip!
You're doing it again!
I got it in the neck.
It's not good, I've just told you it's fine. I've just told them.
They've even thrown out customers.
Out. So just get in your car. Goal.
I'm hitting the streets to find out how Mike and Karen's rows have affected public opinion.
What's the reputation?
Bad.
I used to go there quite a lot, but I got put off by the intense atmosphere, put it that way.
Perhaps they're a bit quick-tempered, maybe, uh-huh. with the customers.
I think the landlord may not always be the most cheerful of people.
Yeah. What I've heard of him, he's a bit of a tosser.
If people sort of say, oh, don't go there, there's argy-bargy going on, you just won't go there.
The Fish and Anchor's reputation is rock bottom. Now I've heard that Mike's got into trouble with the law for rowing with locals. I'm turning marriage counsellor to make Mike and Karen realise that their arguing must stop. If it doesn't, I can't save the Fish and Anchor.
Well, I had a conviction for a public disorder. I mean, not much more than a row.
Yeah.
I'm not proud of the fact that I'd done it.
Whether they're right, you're right, it doesn't matter. But what I'm trying to say, in a business point of view, we can't wash our dirty linen in public. And I don't know if you really understand how bad the reputation is.
The only argument that I witnessed is that it's all work-related. You know, kitchen stuff.
Yeah.
Nothing personal whatsoever.
Absolutely nothing.
Okay. But what I'm trying to say is that the you don't go at it. You don't go at it in a small manner.
No, I understand what you say.
It's the severity of it.
I keep saying to him, there's people in the bar. You can they can hear you.
But Karen, you're both as bad as one another.
I know we are.
I'm just trying to say that we have to turn the fucking corner. And surely you want to.
Of course I do.
And surely you want to. And I'll change it for the best. And you both need to work at it together. And I'll help you with that. You love each other deep down inside, but I don't get that fucking feeling, so I just want it run by a husband and wife that are supporting each other. Yeah?
But I know I've got to calm down, take a chill pill, and just don't get upset over nothing.
We want the reputation as a restaurant for ourselves to be as good as the food we turn out. You know, it's just as important. And I think Gordon has made that clear.
That went really well. I mean, I'd like to think that they both got the message and I think they listened. And I want the locals to understand that there's more to the Fish and Anchor than just fucking arguments. So that has to stop. Now, I can't change the reputation overnight, but what I can do is change this place and help give a new identity and put it back on the map in Lampeter.
My plan is to draw on Mike's Italian roots and turn the Fish and Anchor into an Italian restaurant. First up, get rid of Mike's unworkable menu. It will make everyone's life a lot easier. I've also arranged some temporary help from the local catering college to get a new menu up and running.
Karen? Can I introduce you to somebody?
Yes.
This is Kelly.
Yes.
Yes.
Hello, Kelly.
Karen. Mike, this is Kelly.
Hello.
Hi.
To make things faster and easier for you, I want you to open up and work with Kelly.
I've designed a streamlined Italian menu specially for Mike.
Six starters, six mains, and three desserts. Except there's two of you here tonight, and we go together. The bass, salmon, monkfish, prawns in, shallots, the garlic. It's rustic, easy fish stew.
This new menu's idiot-proof. He'll be able to cook top-quality, rustic dishes easily and quickly.
Tiger prawns in, a tablespoon of pesto, our pine nuts, over. Drain off our pasta, and look, we're away. We're not fucking running over there. Running over there.
Just one step in each direction.
And away. Boom.
These dishes will fly out of the kitchen. It will make for a less pressurised service. And no stress will help Mike and Karen stop rowing.
So it's literally 2 minutes to put that dish together.
You could do that while they're clearing.
Absolutely.
The most important thing from the menu is the speed with which we can put everything together. I mean, it's completely defuse any problems or stress and strains within the kitchen of having to try and, you know, unlike the old menu, trying to achieve something that's almost unachievable.
If he's not stressed in the kitchen, we're not going to be arguing because he's not screaming and shouting at me and I haven't got nothing to shout at him back for.
I've got more than the menu to fix. The key to any restaurant success is creating a welcoming atmosphere.
Kiss me, honey, honey, kiss me.
Meeting Karen is like coming face to face with an uptight Welsh dragon. She's got to relax.
Don't stop.
Sometimes when you go to the table, your face, honestly, I mean, the only thing that's missing is a wasp. You know, I swear to God, you're like that. It's intense and it's like, what the fuck are you gonna order? So, I want you to relax with it.
Some brave souls have volunteered to act as guinea pig customers. It'll allow me to observe Karen and the waitresses closely and lend a helping hand.
Have you been with us before, or is your first time?
Mains, which I call sea bass, please.
Waitresses and Haddad and Mena shine. Professional, courteous. Karen's turn. She's like the ice maiden, completely frozen. Time for a pep talk.
When the customers come in, greet them as if you need them.
Yes.
Don't kiss their ass.
No.
But make them feel welcome.
Take two. She's talking. She's listening, but she's scary.
I am smiling.
One last try. Bingo. A smile.
How are you? Crab cakes are very good. So are the mushrooms.
A full-on Karen charm offensive.
The old man's the chef. He's not the husband, he's the old man. Yes.
I was testing you all.
Not to make you look stupid, but to make the service friendlier. So we're not like this. Like we're still... Yeah? What do you want? Yeah? What do you want? What do you recommend? You've got such a lovely smile when you're in the dining room. People want to see you in here. Push it.
The day of the relaunch of the new Fish and Anchor. But before it can be an Italian restaurant, the awful sports bar decor has to go.
I want to bring a breath of fresh air in here. We're leaning towards something in connection with your grandparents, Italian. So it's, you know, a country fair. It's warm, it's rustic, and it's inviting.
Builders are here. Let's go.
While she's in a good mood, yeah, can we get it going? Yeah, just in case she turns, yeah? Catch that smile. Yeah, it's like the eclipse, comes around once every 4 years.
It's a fresh start for the Fish and Anchor. This new look will help make for a relaxed atmosphere, perfect for welcoming back customers.
Fucking hell.
Take a breath of fresh air. That's what happens sometimes when you're on the wrong road and you can't see it. Can't see the wood for the trees.
And finally, Mike's free of his unworkable menu.
Just by getting rid of what was on that wall, that board, and removing that from my life has been like lifting the world off my shoulders.
Time to unveil the new look to the waitresses, Anharad and Mena.
John, John has the blue. Look at the carpet.
Oh my God, it's cream.
Huh?
Nice and light, and it's not dark as it used to be.
Nice. Mena, what do you think, darling?
Dingy and... Oh, it's fresh.
It's fresh and cheerful.
With the restaurant sorted, it's time to deal with the most crucial bit of the relaunch, winning the trust of the people of Lampeter. I've arranged a ride into town to promote the new Fish and Anchor.
Right. Look at you. Building bridges. We're down. Off to Lampeter. Yes, we're going to get the message out there. We're going to shout from the rooftops the style, yes? Right. What you're doing, where it's coming from, why we're doing it, and we're going to build some bridges. And the reputation is going to be changed, yes? Leaflets, hay bales, canapes, get your ass in there. Hold on tight.
It's the start of a long road to rebuilding this place's reputation.
Get down to the Fish and Anchor. Fantastic, rustic Italian food.
Mike needs to rub shoulders with the locals and he's using his meatballs to win them over.
Simon? What? They're lovely.
Get down to the Fish and Anchor. Delicious meatballs, wonderful pastas.
With no Italian restaurants in Lampeter, there's plenty to shout about. A classy menu and a new look. And most important, a friendlier service.
I can confirm that Karen has agreed to stop arguing. Yes or no?
Yes!
Karen has stopped scaring the customers. She's turned a new leaf. She loves you all.
If Mike and Karen start rowing tonight, they'll undo all the hard work. So I've got a plan. If they get stressed, rather than tearing strips off each other, I'm introducing an anger management prop.
Right, services are quite stressful, yes? Yeah. Tonight, if we get straighted, you... And you are on the naughty step. Bang. Over there. There. Off you go. Get in there, big boy. Come on, get some welly behind it, Karen. Careful you don't get knocked out. There's one big one. Good girl. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. No. So, you take it out on that, yes? Yeah. And you want to scream, and you want to fuck off outside for a cigarette,
yeah.
Yes? Take out on that. OK, how are we feeling?
Excited.
Yes, excited. How are you feeling?
Calm.
Calm?
Collected.
Yeah?
And excited.
OK, good. Right in front of your eyes, on that chair, is your chef's jacket. For a man that's fucking in his late 40s, that's been busting his ass off for the last 20 years, this is your chance. This is your time now. Yeah. Take advantage of it and fucking do it properly. More importantly, enjoy it.
You're
the
chef.
Now you're going to... Cook like a chef, you're gonna look like a chef.
The reckoning. The relaunch of the new Fish and Anchor. This is the biggest fight of Mike's life. For this ex-boxer, it carries the promise of a huge reward. To finally call himself a chef. The people of Lampeter are coming to give the Fish and Anchor a second chance. A golden opportunity for Mike and Karen to redeem this place's reputation.
Try this one. All the stew is lovely.
One antipasti, two prawn and basil, one smoked salmon. Right, yeah, good.
The kitchen's feeling like a professional setup with Mike taking control like a chef.
You call the girls ready for service.
The new menu's doing its job with dishes flying out of the kitchen and going down well.
It looks
Quite simple, quite plain in that respect. It tastes lovely.
Jason thinks the meatballs are brilliant.
Yep. Out front, waitresses Anharad and Mena are keeping the orders rolling in. Crucially, Karen's charming the guests.
You're going to be a good boy. Are you going to be a very good boy all night? Right, what can I get you?
Just 2 days ago, she was shouting at anyone in earshot. Now, she's like a new woman, smiling, chatting, welcoming. The restaurant's now at its capacity. Mike's under pressure.
Starters and table four cleared. Come on, Mike, give me an answer, please.
Starters and table four cleared?
They're clear, yeah. Just check now.
The orders are stacking up and he's panicking.
Whoa, you're going too fast. Listen, whoa, stop.
This is where it really seriously matters now. I'm still unconvinced that this guy can do more than one table at a fucking time. The menu's so idiot-proof, straightforward, easy, country Italian fare, and he's fucking stressing out.
Out front, the food isn't hitting the tables quickly enough.
We'll be drunk before the food comes out.
I'm starving hungry, I'm working all day, and there's nothing happening, it's just graceful.
I'm just not getting saucepans like that under there. I'm going to use the same saucepan over and over.
Mike's teetering on the edge.
Dressing, where's the dressing gone?
This doesn't bode well for the future.
Ladle, can I have some spoons, big spoons?
I'm gutted. And then, the night takes an unexpected turn.
Watch out.
Waitress Mena has slipped on the floor. She's unconscious. It could be serious. An ambulance is called. The night service stops.
She doesn't want to see you like that. Right, stand up. I need the food taken out of the way. Fine. Sad ending. Bad fall. She slipped on the floor and hurt her back. Slight seizure. And went into some form of shock. Taken away in an ambulance. Thankfully, her parents were there. She stayed really calm. And she's in safe hands. I'm convinced she's going to be absolutely fine, but it was a tough night.
I'm back in West Wales. It's a month since the Fish and Anchor's reopening night ended so abruptly when waitress Mena slipped and was taken to hospital. She recovered and went home the next day.
First of all, I'm very relieved the fact that Mena is back to 100% fitness. I'm dying to find out what's actually going on with the Fish and Anchor, because on the launch night, we were halfway through and just struggling to keep our neck above the waters. Has he changed back to his old ways? And when they've got a problem with each other, I hope they're not washing their dirty linen in front of their customers. I don't fucking believe it. He's painted the bloody thing. It looks inviting. That's one bit of good news. Hey.
Hello.
How are you?
Okay.
It looks great out there. How are you, my darling?
Very good.
Are you well?
Yeah.
Yes?
Great, yeah.
Menu, dare I turn around and look at a blackboard?
No.
No?
No. Written menu.
Written menu. Style of food is half Rick Stein, half Gary Rhodes.
No, it's Italian.
Figure-wise, where are we, comparison to last year?
Well, customers, we're double the amount of customers, double the amount of covers.
Yeah.
And as opposed to something like a four and a half grand loss, we're broke even this month.
That's good news. That's very, very positive.
Yeah.
Rowing, stopped?
Stopped.
Must have been one somewhere.
There hasn't.
No?
There. No.
No? We've taken venison off the menu now, anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh? Yeah. I look at venison in a completely different fucking way now. I don't know about you.
A month ago, Mike and Karen's constant rows were driving the customers away. I can't believe they've completely stopped. A quick flick through the reservations book gives me a hotline to recent customers.
Now I just want some fucking background.
Time to find out whether Mike and Karen have truly built bridges with the locals.
Hello, is that Roger?
Yes,
hi, it's Gordon Ramsay. How are you?
Hi, fine. How are you?
What was the food like?
It was brilliant.
What was the atmosphere like in the dining room?
Completely changed.
Good. And the million-dollar question, was there any arguing?
No, none at all.
1-0 to the Fish and Anchor. Sorry, is that Sue?
Mm-hmm.
How was dinner?
It was lovely.
Was the service warm?
Yes.
Anybody shout at you?
No.
Why? No, I'm just asking.
2-0.
Hi, Tony, it's Gordon. You sneaked into the Fish and Anchor recently.
Yeah, it's good enough. I mean, I think there were 10 of us.
10 of you? They serve 10 main courses all at the same time?
Yeah.
You didn't have to take a 2-week holiday in between courses? Fuck, 3-0. There's got to be some negativity somewhere. Do you hear any shouting, screaming?
No,
No, why is that you
doing
there, is it?
Well, no, I'm just asking you, you're the customer, you are the critic.
Thank you, my darling. Bye. Big kiss. For me, it tells me the reputation is spreading. Yeah. And it's spreading in a very positive way.
The word's good. Seeing is believing. Mike's the changed man. A month ago, he was running around the kitchen like a headless chicken. Now he's mastered my menu. Big boy can finally call himself a chef.
Ready for the service here, not a minute, girls.
The dishes are flying out.
My God, it's so quick. Huh? Oh.
And he's in control of his kitchen.
Where's all his orders in? Girls?
Did I hear right, then? You're screaming for orders?
Yeah. These are going out now in a minute, and I've got nothing to get on with.
Out front, the atmosphere is exactly what I was aiming for. Relaxed and welcoming.
Thank you, darling. You can come again.
Now, I'm a little bit nervous.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, it's going really well. You know, he's got 5 tickets on. Yeah, there's harmony. Everybody's smiling. The customer's happy. What's going on?
Nothing.
Huh? The...
Told you so.
Well, the change in him is...
unbelievable. He's proud of himself again.
Yeah, yeah.
For getting things done and quickly, and nobody's complaining.
You look very relaxed.
I am. I'm enjoying myself, actually.
Good. You know those cookbooks we got rid of?
They're gone. Yes.
They've gone and they went to a good cause.
A good cause, yeah.
Now I think it's about time, yeah, you put your own book together. Here we go. Yeah? Not too sure about your sous chef. Look at it carefully and then start filling out your own rustic recipes and cook from here.
Yeah.
Cook from the heart.
Yeah.
And then print it and flog it.
Put it alongside yours on the shelf, see how we go.
Take care.
Ta-da! I think me and Mike have reassessed our marriage. I really, really feel like going on honeymoon again. You know, just go. Me and him going away for a sloppy, daft weekend somewhere. So we may just do that.
Really happy to see it actually working. And for me, the most important thing is we fixed the menu. That means we fixed Mike and Karen. And if they can stick to that, they've got a happy restaurant, happy customers, and more importantly, a happy couple.
Keep young and beautiful.
I've never had a facial before. I had these lines at 21, so what was the point of getting a facial? Karen, do you snort?
Yes.
You do? Do you bottom burp?
No. Never, ever, ever do.
Karen, is that your tummy? What is that?
My girdling plug hole.
Oh, okay. So relaxing.